Hey volunteers, JC here, and I just wanted to say thank you so much for all that you do. And, you know, we struggle every year to think of a new way or an interesting way to say thank you. And this year, we thought it'd be great if the parents of the students that you serve with could tell you thank you themselves. And so what we've done is we've gotten some responses from parents of students and kids that we have in our ministries. And while I can't read all of them to you, I do want to read a few of them just to say thank you. We bring our oldest granddaughter to Brookwood to the 11 o'clock service. She's in the two-year-old class. Price runs to her teacher. She always remembers her name and knows our granddaughter wears hearing aids. They're so involved and attentive to our children. These volunteers are such a blessing, especially for us, to leave them in their care without a worry. My hat goes off to these people. They're invaluable. I can't say enough. We are the grandparents of Alex Marie Stern. Alex has been at Brookwood since she was 4 years old. This is her first year in Crave. I've noticed that Alex has begun to take leadership roles at Brookwood. She is also encountering some bullying in her first year in high school and has been criticized for professing her faith in Christ. The volunteers and staff at Brookwood are so supportive and encouraging to her. I know she feels safe at Brookwood. It's a lot more than a church to her, and that comes from the people who are continually investing in her. We are so grateful we found Brookwood, and Alex is involved in Crave. Thank you, volunteers, for all you do for these high school students. I bring my three-year-old grandson to church as often as possible. He does not attend daycare, so separation was tough at first. The teachers were always patient and kind, so eventually he just handed over his sticker and walked right in. Home life can be frustrating for him sometimes, and he used to get angry very easily. Now I catch him singing Jesus Loves Me and dancing to his own tunes. He asked to go to church and asked his parents if they're going. They haven't yet, but I'm hopeful. When we come to church, we stay as long as possible playing on the playground and walking around. He loves it so much. Thank you so much, volunteers. We recently started going to Brookwood Church, and it was our hope that our 12-year-old son would get involved with the youth program. He's shy and doesn't want to go to the youth church. Instead, for the first couple of times, he attended with us and would only sit with us. We really wanted to get him plugged into the youth group, but he would not go. We were at a soccer game and began talking with another couple, and it turned out that they had been members at Brookwood for some time. They told us they volunteer in the early service for the youth afterwards. They go and sit in the main sanctuary. We shared with them our situation with him not wanting to go into the youth service, and they offered to take him with them and their son. The following Sunday, they came to our house and picked Jacob up to take him to the early service. We all met in the second service and sat together. Jacob shared with us how much fun he had and how he really enjoyed the service. This has been such a blessing and turned into a wonderful friendship for us all. If this sweet couple, the Baileys, didn't have a serving heart and ministering spirit, none of this would have taken place. It's been an answer to our prayers. God's truly using the volunteers at Brookwood to touch hearts and lives of young and old alike. We are so thankful He has brought us to Brookwood, and we hope to be a part of the body of believers here for many years to come. Now, we know being in family ministry that sometimes there are things that you do that don't get noticed, and oftentimes you even wonder, am I making an impact at all? But I can just tell you, from my perspective and the perspective of our family ministry staff, we're so appreciative of what you do. But not only us, but as we receive these emails from parents, they're so thankful for you too. So from the bottom of our hearts, no matter if you're a greeter or if you're a Sunday school leader or if you are a worship team or you're a part of production in the back or you're somebody who just makes sure that everyone is safe and having a good time, or you teach from the stage, whatever your role is, you're appreciated by the parents and by us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Make that change.